this opportunity to congratulate all of the district-wide graduating class of 2017 for a job well done. It is a distinct honor and privilege for me to address you this evening. I know it hasn't been easy, but your presence here tonight means that you persevere and that you made it. You made it! Let's reminisce for a minute. Almost half of you have been students at Saltus for 13 years. Let your minds roll back to that most ancient time, the Saltus year P1. Remember all the excitement and trepidation? You were only 5 years old, and your greatest aspiration was to be just like the big kids. To advance and become one of the Saltus P2 students. You were willing to do everything you could to climb the first rung of that ladder of success. And you've been climbing a series of Saltus academic ladders ever since. From the top of the lower primary ladder, you leapt onto the bottom rung of the upper primary ladder, and from the top of the upper primary ladder, you leapt onto the bottom rung of the Saltus middle and secondary ladder in your tireless Super Mario Brothers quest for greater knowledge and academic advancement. Then comes the Saltus SGY ladder, and it's only 2 years. Sweet. After finishing the combined 5 years of middle and high school, 2 years is a piece of cake, right? Wrong. What they didn't tell you is that the monumental workload that they packed in for you for those 2 years, so you dig in, working like fiends to master it all. You freak out just figuring it out, and you manage to complete your SGY first year. A year ago, as you stood atop the SGY ladder, buffeted by the swirling high winds of self-doubt and introspection, people would ask, "So, where do you go from here?" Or, "Have you decided now what you want to do for the rest of your life?" Don't you just cringe when people ask you those questions? Sometimes you'd probably just like to relax, celebrate, and bask in the glow of your enduring family and friends, letting them admire your accomplishments. But somehow life never quite works like that. This brings to mind what must have been the great epiphany for Saltus year 6. You're about 10 years old, and you are struck by the cruel reality that the only reward for correctly solving a difficult math problem, for example, is being assigned a more difficult math problem the very next day. Even so, you have triumphed. You have earned your Rocky Balboa raised your hands in the air moment. And the quest now comes as you leave Saltus to make your way in an exciting but very uncertain world. The uncertainty takes on many, many forms. How do we prevent further global warming to protect our fragile environment? How do we create and sustain job growth to reduce unemployment before you enter the job market? How do we prevent the spread of nuclear armaments to additional countries, some of which a highly belligerent or unstable? How do we properly care for the elderly as the cost of health care spirals upward and as people live longer and longer? The list of these critical issues goes on and on and on. It is ironic that in these highly uncertain times, we have more data at our fingertips than at any time in the history of our planet. Information alone does not eliminate uncertainty. In our current information age, it has been said that everyone knows everything, and yet no one knows what it all really means. Uncertainty abounds. And yet, this very uncertainty showers us with opportunities. The great 19th century French poet, Charles Baudelaire, observed that through uncertainty, we find the future. Through uncertainty, we find the future. It has always been so. In the late 15th century, Christopher Columbus and his associates all believed that the earth was flat and were uncertain what would happen when they sailed to the edge of the world. Instead, they discovered that the earth was round, which heralded the future of transoceanic exploration. During the Second World War, the Allies raced against the Nazis to develop a secret new technology called radar that could enable an army to see enemy aircraft that otherwise was not visible to the naked eye. It was very uncertain which side would win this crucial technology race and perhaps even who would win the war. Radar stations were eventually installed on the base lands in Bermuda. As technicians from an American company called Raytheon worked to refine the new technology, they worked all around the new radar dishes, and they walked all around the new radar dishes. One technician noticed that as he passed the radar dish, the chocolate bar in his pocket melted. Shortly after this discovery, Raytheon introduced the world's first microwave ovens, which created a more certain future for the culinary habits of dormitory students worldwide. Through uncertainty, we find the future. The world is fraught with uncertainty. It's not your fault. And there's no escaping it. Baudelaire suggests, however, that we view uncertainty as the portal through which we access the future, the cauldron in which we forge the future. He's inviting us to harness the uncertainty and work it to the best of our ability. So you need to work it real good. On a personal level, as you pursue your futures in our uncertain world, you will make mistakes. At least that is certain. Embrace these mistakes and learn from them. A mistake should not define you or your future potential in a negative way unless you allow it. As former First Lady of the United States, Eleanor Roosevelt, wisely noted, no one can make you feel inferior without your consent. It is how you comport yourself when you make a mistake that reveals not only your intelligence, but your character as well. Own your mistakes. Don't blame others. Take personal responsibility. Each mistake can become a valuable learning opportunity. uncertainty, we find the future. But sometimes you have to look back from the past. I know this from personal experience. Actually, it was 20 years ago this year that I had become the premier, the first woman and the only person to serve as premier of the community. And sometimes it seems only yesterday, which is a testament to how quickly the years are passing. And then it also feels like a lifetime ago, only a distant memory. Life is like that. Anticipation of things to come and reflection of things past. At the time, the political landscape felt very uncertain. How would the male-dominated House of Assembly respond to the leadership of a woman? How would older political veterans respond to the leadership from the younger generation? Facing these challenges enabled me to break some glass ceilings and resulted in a future characterized by more diverse leadership at the highest level of community government. Later, as I took on the challenges of earning an MBA or becoming a teaching fellow at Harvard University's Kennedy School of Government, success was not certain. Hard work and perseverance allowed me to prevail, and that definitely helped to shape my future. Your successful future may also be found by working through present uncertainty. Perhaps the ancient writers of the Sanskrit proverbs put it best. For yesterday is but a dream, and tomorrow is only a vision. But today, well lived, makes every yesterday a dream of happiness, and every tomorrow a vision of hope. Look well, therefore, to this day. Here's the key. Look well, therefore, to this day. Carpe diem, seize the day. Make the most of today, each and every day, and thereby securing your amazing future. So brace yourselves, buckle up, and let the wind and the wild and wonderfully uncertain ride begin. I wish you continued success and great joy now and in the years to come. Good luck. And my sincere congratulations.